Bad Boys franchise is like literally one of my favorites.
Oh, well, thank you, thank you, thank you.
What took you guys so long to come out with number 3?
This guy. This guy. He wouldn't do it unless it was right, to his credit. He wanted his script to be right, and every time it came in and it wasn't right, he kept turning it back in. So until we got it right.
I didn't want to mess it up. I didn't want to mess it up.
Because everyone loves it so much, you don't want to be like, you don't want to go out on bottom.
You don't want them to go down.
Totally.
Just a steady down. One was great, and then you go down and go down.
Exactly. So what was it like, you know, being together again, you know, for the first time in how many years has it been?
16,
yeah, since the last one. That's great. 25 years since the first one. Yeah. Crazy.
I feel so old right now.
I know. you were like 6 when the first
much.
One.
So what was it like to work together again?
Oh, great. Yeah, just to be back with this guy after all them years, it's just like we never missed each other, never stopped working. It's like riding a bike again.
You know, I learned a lot about myself and about friendship on this tour, and it's like you just understand somebody. You can't love somebody you don't understand.
Yeah.
Right? And it's like, I just get Martin. He gets me. We get each other, which makes us know how to be there for each other. It's a really, it's a beautiful thing.
I was happy to see in the trailer, like, all the hallmarks of the Bad Boy franchise. You with the slow motion putting on the suit. You're looking like you're going to throw up when he's driving. It's like the best. Did you know that Jerry Bruckheimer, I just talked to him, and he said you guys were not the first duo to be considered. John Lovitz and Dana Carvey?
Yes.
Come on.
That would have been a total different
movie. It would have been a little different.
Absolutely. Yeah. So, you know, what's changed with the two of you, you know, over the since the first one came out in this movie? Like,
I'm a lot heavier than the first one. But not a lot.
Other than that, everything.
But it was for the role.
Yeah. You know, you like thickened up. We both thickened up a little bit for the role.
I love it. So I heard you guys are now honorary Miami police officers.
Yeah.
So
that was actually cool. Yeah. Like, they gave us badges, and we got like the ID card and all that stuff.
Keys to the city.
I felt like, you know, the key to the city was really cool, but the badge, I don't know why. It felt really good. It's like Miami is like the third cast member of the Bad Boys, you know. So
totally.
It was really, it's critical to be there, and the city loves the franchise, and how it makes the city look, and how the people feel about it. It was beautiful to be there with that.
I love it. Okay, and so individually, what projects do you guys have coming up in 2020?
2020.
Well, right now I'm about to go on tour.
Is this the Lit AF tour?
Yes. And so we'll be in arenas all around, cities coming near you, the best comedians out, so come check us out.
Absolutely.
Love it.
I got a thing, I'm about to start a movie, it's called King Richard, about Richard Williams, Venus Serena's father, and how he trained them to be the top tennis players on earth.
Excellent. Are you guys going to be at the Super Bowl?
No, that's hectic. Yeah, I was like, Miami is great, but for the Super Bowl, it's going to be real.
Yeah. Bad. Well, now that you guys are honorary police officers, maybe you guys can enforce the rule of law.
Yes, exactly.
Right?
Thank you for watching. If you want more extra, hit the subscribe button and the bell so you'll never miss a video.